to another episode of Empowered, Hawaii's clean energy future. While the climate crisis impacts all of us throughout the world, one age group seems to have a particularly vested interest in addressing it, our youth. This is their future that they're fighting for, and they want their voices to be heard.
Tonight, we will see how Hawaii's youth are working towards a brighter future, find out what programs are available, and be reminded why this all matters. First, hear from three local high school students on their experience as part of Blue Planet Foundation's Climate Crew.
Hi, I'm Kayla Kimura.
I'm Aiden Gregerson.
Hi, I'm Lucy Fagan.
And we're part of Blue Planet Foundation's Climate Crew.
What do you tell people when they ask about your Climate Crew t-shirt? Like, what do you tell them about the crew?
So I usually tell people that the Climate Crew is a program by Blue Planet Foundation. It helps high school students turn their passion for the environment into action. And they do that through teaching them how to advocate through legislation and public outreach. We kicked off the Climate Crew by going to a climate camp where we got training on advocacy and climate science.
We were lucky we got to do an in-person climate camp before the pandemic. And we were really able to learn about the fundamentals of climate science. And we also learned how to storytell and actually take action, which really gave me the fundamental understanding and skills I needed to go and take action on the climate crisis.
One thing I was excited about as being part of the Climate Crew was that after climate camp, we were tasked with going into our individual communities and performing climate actions. This year at my high school, I've actually been working on trying to lead several different organizations, like the National Honor Society, for example. And I'm trying to give students on Kauai an opportunity, which I feel like we don't get many of on Kauai, so that they can take actions against climate change that we normally wouldn't be able to.
As a whole cohort, we worked on a project we called the Bike Lane Bonanza, and that was a social media challenge to get people to use the new bike lanes in town. So you post pictures on your bike in the bike lanes, and then you'd be entered to win some cool prizes.
Legislation ended up being a big one for myself and for others. I went to Honolulu Hale and testified twice on city council bills. And then also we got a bill passed, Bill 25, which updated energy codes to support EV and make buildings more energy efficient. We got that passed, and I was actually able to attend the signing of that bill with the mayor.
Some of my biggest takeaways from the Climate Crew were relating to leadership skills. So I learned a lot about how to kind of talk to people, how to get people working together, but I also learned how to be a community member. And I was glad to learn that big actions relating especially to climate change are a lot easier when done together.
I think that the climate crisis is really the fight of our generation, because it's going to be defining our futures and then the generation after us, their future. And so it's really our responsibility to take this on. Climate Crew was the first time I really felt empowered to get involved in a community that I previously thought was reserved for adults. But through the Climate Crew, you realize that there's a place for students and high schoolers, and we have a unique voice because we are of a younger generation.
I think my biggest takeaway was that there's a whole community of people out there that really want to make change. And it doesn't matter what our age is or who we are, we are able to engage in that community and really make that change and be involved. And that was really powerful and inspiring.
It's important for youth to get involved with climate action because we're the ones who are going to lead the world of tomorrow. It's our kuleana to do what we can now for a better future tomorrow, because we're the ones who have to live in it. My experience attending the United Nations Youth Climate Summit was amazing. I was selected as a Hawaii candidate to attend the summit, and in wake of the climate marches all around the world that were happening and the climate injustice that was happening, the United Nations wanted to host a summit, a youth summit, and invite kids from all around the world. During the summit, we talked a lot about the IPCC report, which stated that in just a few years, in under 10 years, the effects that humans have caused to the environment would be irreversible. And even just a few years later, we see the effects and how it's hurting other countries along with our island. It was really impactful, and just trying to bring it home and trying to share what I learned with the folks around the island, with my peers at school. I attended Blue Planet Energy Summit back in 2018. That was my first one. It was really cool because I was able to interact with other students, not only just from Oahu, but from other islands as well. In 2019, I attended my second Blue Planet Energy Summit. I was actually a keynote speaker. Speaking at the 2019 Energy Summit as a keynote speaker was amazing. Being able to interact with all the other high schoolers that were there and just seeing their expression and actually being able to connect with them on a personal level, I hope it encouraged them to know that they could do the same. Working with students from across the state at the Blue Planet Energy Summit was inspiring. It felt like a ripple effect, because I know what they learned at the Energy Summit, they brought it home to their communities. They brought it home to their schools, and to their peers, and to their parents, and will continue to ripple and continue to create change in the community.
As a remote island chain in the middle of the Pacific, Hawaii has a significant relationship with the ocean that surrounds us. The beautiful blue water is one of the best parts of island life, but with our changing climate, it also threatens our shores.
Sea level rise, beach erosion, and ocean acidification are just a few of the effects of climate change happening here in Hawaii. Hear how our youth are protecting our marine ecosystems and cleaning up our beaches.
I grew up on the east side of Honolulu, and I grew up surfing from a very young age. So for the first like 10 to 15 years of my life, I was surfing every single day, and I started doing amateur surf competitions. And being in the water every day meant that I connected really quickly to the environment. And then that also meant that I was witnessing, you know, sea level rise and ocean acidification and all these really detrimental things to our environment. And so when I got to high school, I was introduced to community service. That's kind of where I got my start and became really passionate about environmental activism and decided to pursue that in college. So when I first got introduced to environmental activism, I initially got involved with plastic pollution work, and then I kind of expanded a little bit into clean energy with Blue Planet Foundation. And then now our work is kind of, for next semester, is going to be focused on sustainable tourism and advocating for that. And then personally, I've also been working on encouraging diversity and equity within environmental organizations and just trying to make sure that our work is as effective and inclusive as possible. One simple thing that the youth can do is have conversations with people, whether it's their friends or parents or teachers or really just anyone in their community. Conversations have the power to open people's minds and also empower them to be an agent of change in their community. I know that it can be really intimidating, but really once you do it, you recognize that everyone is really welcoming to hearing your perspective and having you get involved. And so don't be afraid to do that. Just another simple thing is getting involved with local organizations. And kind of working with the land and understanding the history of the place. I'm always proud of the moments of whenever I'm able to kind of like help introduce someone to being an agent of change in their community, especially when we're talking about things like climate change, which seem like the weight of the world is on your shoulders and it's so daunting and you can't grasp it. But to be able to help someone recognize that, no, I have the power to actually kind of help to stop climate change or make sure that our communities are going to survive, that's the most empowering and beautiful thing to watch. So it feels really gratifying to know that whenever I see an issue in my community or injustice that I don't agree with, I have the power to be able to fight for myself or my family or the people that I care about and make sure that we are living in a future and a world that we actually want to be living in.
HIMB, or the Hawaii Institute of Marine Biology, is a research facility located on Mopo'olo'e, otherwise known as Coconut Island, which is in the middle of Kanyohe Bay. So this unique location really gives researchers on the island a very special opportunity to conduct research with incredible access to field work and sampling. And so we have labs here that are focused on pretty much all areas of marine science, everything from marine microbes to marine mammals. Hi, my name is Mariko Quinn, and I am currently an undergraduate researcher at the Hawaii Institute of Marine Biology, otherwise known as HIMB. So I was actually born and raised right on the water on Kanyohe Bay, and I went to Castle High School, and I'm currently a sophomore at UH Manoa, majoring in global environmental science. A lot of the work that I've done is very directly related to the climate crisis. Currently, in the Hagedorn Lab, we're working on a project to be able to cryopreserve the symbionts of corals. The cryopreservation is really important because it creates a biobank that we can go back to hundreds of years in the future. And so this kind of restoration method is really important to learn more about in Hawaii as we move forward with the climate crisis. Even though we want to prevent the worst, we also have to prepare for it. So in the event of a very worst case scenario, such as a hurricane or something that would wipe out large populations of coral, we want to have a backup plan.
Aloha, my name is Sienna Craig Garcia, and at the Hawaii Institute of Marine Biology, I am a post-undergrad educator and researcher. I am currently working with the education program known as REMS, or Research Experience in Marine Science, under the direction of Dr. Malia Rivera. My work specifically with this program is really educating students, educating the future about different aspects of marine science, and a lot of it has to do with climate change. Looking at the different modules we do, we really try to expose our students to anthropogenic stressors or human-caused stressors that are happening in our marine environment, and showing them the direct effects that our human actions are causing on these marine species. And being in Hawaii, a lot of students are like really passionate about the ocean and they want to save it. And a lot of times we just don't know how because we don't have those resources to be educated. So REMS and HIMB is a really great resource for these local students to get out and learn and hopefully take it home to their parents and teaching their families.
I think one of the biggest things that younger people can do is educating themselves on their own impact on the climate and how they're influencing climate emissions, or carbon emissions, and things like that. But another big thing is voting. Voting for people as soon as they can, voting for representatives that'll push for renewable energy and clean energy and lowering emissions and things like that.
Personally, I feel like being able to have an impact on students in order to make that change in Hawaii and on the globe for climate change, it's really empowering. I first wanted to be a scientist doing hands-on research in the lab, but after working with students, I've really seen the impact that instructors are able to have on students to also feel empowered to make a difference in the world.
I definitely have future plans for climate activism. I'm actually a minor in political science at UH. I think that really, like, we have the solutions for climate change. People have done the research. We know it needs to be done. But what needs to happen is we need to have people in government that are putting those changes into action.
Youth around the world are leading the way in climate advocacy, from testifying in the legislature to organizing peaceful protests. The more students continue to educate themselves on climate science and policy, the more their voices are being heard.
Here at home, Hawaii students are doing their part in this global movement with numerous educational programs available. See how one company's partnership with a local high school is helping to make a difference.
Aloha, my name is Carlos Kokahi Nakoa Labasan Severson, and I'm the agriculture kumu here at Castle High School. I teach several different agriculture courses, including natural resources, plant systems, and directed studies entrepreneurship. Castle High School's program is aimed at how do we make pono with the aina in order to make money so that we can sustain our families. And the other side is agriculture science. So how do we learn a little bit more about how to be mahi'ai and grow better food and be more sustainable and utilize science in a pono way.
Aloha, I'm Jake Ferreira. I'm a junior and I go to Castle High School. This is my second year in the ag program. I actually really enjoy this program, enjoyed it so much that I switched out of one of my other electives just to come into this class twice. We grow a lot of things. He likes to teach us about kalo and anything about nutrients that goes into the soil, mulching, how to keep things sustainable, like watering, taking care of the land, and making sure that the land can take care of us for the future generations to come. Because if we don't take care of it now, we won't have it in the future.
Our partnership with Sumo Farms really is to look at how do we become more sustainable in terms of energy in Hawaii. We have just millions and millions of tons of oil and non-renewable resources being brought into Hawaii to power electric and as well as gas. So in Hawaii, more than 40% of available agricultural lands are just empty. And we need to be able to do something with it. So if we took those lands and we were able to grow like the banana grass crop or some other type of renewable energy, then that would bring us closer and closer to being sustainable like the indigenous peoples were, the Hawaiians were.
Growing banana grass is not difficult. It's basically just water and you let it do its own thing like a tree. Just weeding around it a little bit, keeping it healthy. From planting to harvesting the banana grass, it takes from 10 to 12 weeks, approximately.
So once the banana grass is harvested, it's taken to a macerator and it's just chopped up, and that slurry and that mass is then put into a digester. Inside the digester, you have a cocktail of bacteria and microbes that then eat the starch content inside of the grass, and it converts it into natural gases. It's very similar to how a cow operates. The cow will eat the grass, the enzymes will break it down, the gases come out, but instead of going into the atmosphere, you're capturing it and utilizing it for energy.
I'm proud that I'm able to be able to grow banana grass to turn it into renewable energy because I live here and I'd like to see Hawaii the way it is now to become better and more sustainable in the future. It's mainly important for us to be sustainable locally because we don't really want to rely on mainland imports because that mainland import may not always be there. I mean, we're only a little island in the ocean, so we got to learn to be somewhat sustainable here. To younger students who are thinking about joining agriculture, do it. Do as much as you can. Get involved. It may seem like a lot of work at first, but that work will turn into a lot of fun.
When my students graduate from high school, what I want them to really understand and to remember are the values that they get. So one of them really is, how do you connect to the aina? How do you regard the aina as something that's alive? So building that relationship with the aina is like building that relationship with our ohana, and then at large, building that relationship with the community. If they can take some of those pieces, they'll be better sons and daughters, and that would make me feel really good.
Aloha, my name is Jade Frank. I'm the Communications Director at the Hawaii Youth Climate Coalition, a nonprofit youth-led organization that focuses on mitigating the climate crisis through advocacy and education. All of our members are college age or younger, and I think that it's really empowering and important to have a youth-led space in activism because you can see what you, specifically as a youth, can do. The Youth Climate Strikes were an international effort that mobilized thousands of people in Hawaii and hundreds of thousands of people all around the world. And that kind of work, when you're seeing all of these people rallying towards a single cause, is just incredibly satisfying and fulfilling. And you know your work is going towards a really big, important goal. The main message of that day was really that we have a problem and that we need to address it right now. I think that one really impactful yet pretty simple way to get involved is by writing testimony. The HYCC actually makes guides on how to submit testimony to the legislative website, which I think can be really useful for those who may be inexperienced in activism. One other way is also by joining a school club, perhaps, if your school has one, or even starting one. The HYCC provides support for both new clubs and existing clubs through our club network. And finally, I think that there's also a lot of choices that you can make in your everyday life, like reducing your carbon footprint or your food waste, bringing reusable utensils or bags wherever you go, and also by just proactively educating yourself. As a Kanaka Maoli in Hawaii, I do think that it's really important to be involved in the protection of our land, water, ecosystems, and other natural resources. I really do think that it's everyone's responsibility, but also a privilege to be a part of a movement that works towards creating a brighter, more sustainable, and equitable future for everyone.
We hope these stories from Hawaii's youth have inspired you. In a time when so much is uncertain, our youth have become a beacon of hope, leading us towards a brighter future for all.
While our climate challenge is real and at times overwhelming, let these stories motivate you to find your own way to get involved with climate actions in your community. Until next time, aloha.
We hope you enjoyed tonight's episode of Empowered. Blue Planet Foundation is committed to accelerating Hawaii's clean energy future through bold policy, creative storytelling, and impactful community programs. As a public charity, our work is largely supported through the generosity of individuals. To join our journey to Hawaii's 100% renewable energy future, we invite you to make a donation at blueplanetfoundation.org. Mahalo.